paper. This paper is supposed to be presented by one of my junior. His name is called Chinakham Dina Singh. At present, he is working here in Thailand as a teacher. As well as he is doing the research work of the Tai Lai, taking help from the Thailand people as well as from this society itself. Since this paper is prepared by him, I may be having some confusion in between the best criticized of this to understand what he has written. But before presenting it, I would like to mention one thing also. See, I myself wrote the title. I realized very recently. Earlier, though I am a scheduled caste, though I am a Thai guy, I did not know all about this. But it was known to me that we people that Nandu and Sigma especially, and there are many other scheduled caste villages also. But this group, since I came to the art, I realized why we are coming from there. We are not Hindu. We are not Christian. What we are? I was really confusing. The better part, my mother and my brother, they tried their best to find out some clue. And now I realize that, oh, I am from the right community. So this is only the beginning. So I'll present this paper, what my brother, Mr. Dina, has written in this paper, in his paper. The time it lived. The Lai ethnic. Lai is an ethnic group of people settling in Manipur. Lai is one of the earliest settlers in Manipur. According to Dr. Ramachandra, early settlement and early names of Manipur, 1993. He has given some reference also. Yeah. Lai people are settling in Myanmar, Mizoram, and China, as well as it is mentioned in a book which I have presented it to the sir, Green Bukhanji. So it is written by Sheesh Dina and Kenneth Biren, my brother is here. The first king of Manipur, Pakhangba. The first king of Manipur, it's a Pakhangba. So he belonged to the Lai community. During the power struggle in the history of Manipur, Lai was suppressed and different names were given to the ethnic group as Chakpa, Loi, etc. So we have been misnamed, misnominated, and we were given the, what you say, the ethnic group of Chakpa and Loi, etc. The Lai ethnic, presently known as Loi, a term, the meaning from subdued, is different group from the other ethnic group. Settled in Manipur, the group have been categorized separately from Meitei, Naga, Kuki, etc. The Manipur People Bill 2018 is passed by the Manipur Legislative Assembly on 23rd, 2018. Andro and the Semai village belong to Lai ethnic. Andro is 25 km east of Imphal and Sekmai 19 km towards the north from Imphal. While going to Imphal, before reaching Imphal, we will find our village. See, this very word Lois, it has different meaning, one is exact. But this Lois is a term derived the meaning from subdue, because we refuse. And we were away from this group, that kind of, I mean, things that there is a subdued, not the, what is exact. And see, we have been, I mean, we are different from this Meitei. Though I am Moranhat, though they are Khwairakpam, same thing is there with the Meitei also. But our status is kept differently, away from this Meitei, Naga, Kuti, etc. The Manipur People Bill 2018, it is there. And the migration is migration in the history regarding the how we migrated from the this different part to the Manipur, it is written. The oral history narrates that the Lai group left Shankian, a place in the northeastern island, and moved along Mekong River, then entered Myanmar, earlier Burma. So they crossed the Saluin River of Myanmar, reached Sanstead, and settled around Awale. This place where the Lai people lived was known as Lai Hakka. This is in Burma. Still, I think the place is there. In this region, Lai people were believed to settle for about half a century. From there, the group moved to Chin state of Myanmar, keep changing in the Myanmar of Burma, and finally reached Manipur Valley. They established a kingdom at Yenban. Earlier, Imphal was called Yenban. The early name of Imphal is called Yenban, present day Imphal. It was known as Mount Pali. It is also known as the Mount Pali. Administrative duty. Today, Lai people settle at the foothills of Manipur Valley. Manipur, I think most of you have seen it. It is surrounded by the ranges, hills, but in middle that four districts. This Imphal East, Imphal West, Thawar, and Vishnupur district. At present, one more addition is there, that Kachin district. These districts are Beli, and then other districts, Hilly area. So this is somewhat like a certain time covered with a gallery. This time. Today, the Lai people should be put in their status has been given scheduled caste. In the year 1954 or 55, there was a commission led by Dr. Kaka Kaleka, an MP. Then recognized as the scheduled caste, which is what I feel is misnomination. In order to get some benefits, like reservation from the government, even though the group is not Hindu. Scheduled caste means the lowest class of the Varna system of Hindu culture. So we are not that, we are not Hindu. But how we are recognized as the scheduled caste? This is very questionable. Because the caste system is related to Hinduism, this is my very clearly written about it. The village have peculiar setting with village head, administrative role, exactly similar like a small kingdom. Even today, we have village head and administrative roles, exactly similar with a different, like a different country we have. And this shows that the Lai group is related to the ruling administration, and Pakhang, the first king, belonged to Lai group. Because the first king, Pakhang belonged to the Lai group. And we are the, what you say, the follower and the sons of the king, the ruling class. And regarding the Lai script, they go. Come. Lai people have their own Lai script known as Lai Ling. That Lai, the script is called Lai Book. Lai Book means Lai Shu. Lai Ling and Lai Shu. If it is book, it's a Lai Shu. If it is only the script, then it's a Lai Ling. There are 35 Lai letters with an additional symbol called Anchi, derived from Anchi, dedicated to the person who introduced the Lai group. There are 5 letters, including one additional symbol, which is dedicated to the producer, that the very person who introduced this Lai script. Modern Manipuri script is derived from this Lai script. But the name has been recorded as another name, unfortunately. We lost our original language in spite of the maintaining the live stream. Actually, ours is 35 letters with addition of this symbol called Anji, that is 36. So at present, the what is the original, what to say, this script is only 27 or something like that. So that means they borrowed it from the bigger one and they made it, what you say, small one, just to say that it is there. So they stole the script like this. The original Lai language is very similar to Thai language. We found it, this language, our language is very similar to the Thai language. The counting is very similar to Thai counting. Thai. And the counting codes is Nun, Song, San, Si, Ha, Hu, Je, Pe, Kao, Si, etc. 1, 2, 3, and 10, up to 10. Yes, written it. So, the different, so far we discussed previous days. In the previous days, we discussed the difference is Hu. Yours is Lu. I think the Tai Ahom. Ahom Tai. The number 6, that is different. We call it Hu. And you call it, sir, look, it's like this. So, after losing the original language, Lai people adopted Sakata language of Manipur. That old one, we have lost everything. And again, there is another difference. Then, this we adopted another, what is it, language, that is called Sakato. So, after losing original language, Lai people adopted Sakato language of Myanmar, according to the friendly of last of University of Australia, confirmed this in email to him. My brother had an ill man message from this fellow, and he confirmed that this, we adopted this Sakato. This Sakato language is locally known as Sakpa language. The Sakato language is locally known as Chakpa language. It has been named again Chakpa language. At present also, some of the people they understand this, what is Chakpa language. There is record that some people could speak this language till 1850. Up to 1850, the Sakato was used by our people. And difference is also given. Then we pick up the Thai language, which is used by we people presently, and it is also called Manipuri. So this is our Thai language. Since we left our own tongue, we change. Which, well, now it's called Metebo. They use their own name, which is not true. But it is a Manipuri language now. It's in a Manipuri language. It's like that. But how it is happened, so it will come in following times. Burning of Puya means the record. Puya means the record of our community. It was destroyed like anything with the force of the king and monarchy, and their adoption, their what is conversion into religion. So, Lai people were associated with the scholarly work as scribe at royal palace during early period. When the Hinduism came, a devastating consequence brought into as a result of cultural change in Manipur. Most of the important books, documents related to Lai people were destroyed by burning during the early adoption period of Hindu religion by the king in 1700. The burning of the Puya Maithava, that is called Puya Maithava, took place 3 times, according to the Mayamon Mamu Kiran Kumar. It is known to the Eastern Indian squad of Manipur.
During the time of the King Karibani was, that is also called Pamhiva. The deaths were recorded as first one, the February 1725. Second, Thursday, 23rd January 1729. And third, Sunday, 17th October 1732. In such three times of burning the Puyan, all the records and the relevant documents were destroyed by the force of the king with power. And although all those documents were destroyed, and then new writings were forbidden by the king. You are not supposed to write anything. It was forced by the king. But still then, our forefathers were watching us. And how we left the script. It is somewhat like a drama or something like what is it? Lila type. So it is called Lai Harava. Lai means people. Harava means happiness, joy, all these things. It's in a form of worshipping of the ancestor. After burning almost all the Lai books, after the conversion to Hinduism, scholarly work of reading and writing was prohibited. It is said. So, in order to keep the history, a ritual ceremony of storytelling was introduced. Is Lai Harava, Chiang Mai. Now, Chiang Mai was its court for the first time in the year 1860 AD. During the reign of the King Marjit of Manipur, 1819 to 1819. This period was very short, but during that period, that Lai Harava was, what is it, introduced. All the important history of the Lai people hid in Lai Harava. In this very kind of the ceremony, everything is there. Even our Madam Khwairakpam Sadakul from Thailand, she has in this year. So, only what is it, if we can interpret it properly, then story, I think. So he has written. So in order to keep the history and ritual ceremony of history, all the important history of the people hid in the Lai Harava not to be seen by others, is the ceremony was designed as an act of a cultural and historical secrecy of the group due to the restriction and opposed by the then ruler. If we rewrite this thing, then will be killed, that person will be killed. So yes, what is it? Leave it with this function. Now the identity conflict. But here is written very seen. In the power struggle history of Manipur, many Lai disappeared and merged to the other community, and their identity had not come to the surface. Because king, they are powerful, so the people, they feel that we should, what is it, convert into Hinduism or Buddhism or something like that. Like this, through the many reasons, they disappeared. And we have come to the surface. Interestingly, the present Lai group of Manipur have never changed their identity when Hinduism conversion took place quietly in Manipur around 300 years ago. So, sir and everybody there, we know that there was a strong wave from the Hindu society that before 300 years ago, there was a strong conversion of Hinduism with the help of a king of Manipur. It was taken place in Manipur. So during that time, in the community surrounded by the majority group, there came cultural influence. However, people still maintain the old culture of the Lai original people. Because we are very, what to say, resistant, and we are very, what to say, our forefathers, they used to tolerate so much that they still continue their original culture, refusing to follow the Hinduism and Buddhism. That remains there with our villagers and the Andro. Yes, most of the literary works were destroyed during the beginning stage of the Hinduism spreading to Manipur. Lai people lost most of the important works and the remaining cultural elements could not be investigated properly due to the lack of the resource, and people are confused their own identity. So the delimitized language, where it can be a kind of person, as I told you earlier before reading out this book. So, Lai people, what we believe, Lai people worship Lai ancestors. We don't have a self god and everything. We think that this is for part of their creator, like this. So they are our, what is a god. So that means we worship our ancestors. Lai people worship Lai ancestors. Sorareng, Sawang, Kogu are some of the names mentioned popularly in the Lai community. So Pakhalwa is also in that. Track. People worship Khamdong. Khamdong, destination. Khamdong is worshipped as the god of rain. Khamdong is the god of the rain. In reality, Khamdong is the sacred place of the Lai people. This is considered as a god which represent the land where our ancestors came from. That means from where we started. That means our ancestors from where they started. This is personified as a god and supreme creator. He is also called a Suraren. In a literary word, when someone passes away, the soul goes to the origin of our forefathers lay. But in layman's term, we die, we will go to heaven, the place where Soraren lives. Soraren comes from rains and water. Literature tries to connect the story to heaven, the place where the rain comes from. People also worship rash gods. We also worship water of the Mekong River is Lai Mare. See, Mekong is a river which flows in the Myanmar. God of the rain, god of water, local god of the protector, the family god are all our ancestors. So, on some special ceremony, outsiders are not allowed to enter the village during the ceremony. Even we don't allow the other to enter our village. The living symbol is there in the Andro, that is the birthplace of the village. So, see, we have been doing this, what we have been doing is written. Wet rice cultivation is the most important profession. Sticky rice food is important with our culture. In a ritual ceremony. Other jobs are making rice beer, rice wine, rice whiskey. Pottery, rearing and making silk cloth, keeping poultry and pickery, cane and bamboo works are other jobs of the community. So, it is mentioned by my brother, but during my short presence here and the interaction with Tai Ahom, I found this kind of potential profession similar with ours. So, that means we are members confirmed with that. We are, what is it, the people of Tai, that is very much confirmed. Food and drink, pork and chicken are most important food. This is our third. No, we also love it. We have that there in the Hathi Barua and all. It was very nice experience. These are very important food But pork is very special for the ethnic group. People drink rice here, rice wine, and rice whiskey. And the Lai group are specializing in extracting this thing. Rice whiskey is extracted through distillation, and Lai people use it for treatment and health care. So some people are saying that the wine is very bad, but it's good. Even the rice is also very bad. If you misuse it, we should not take it. If we use it properly, it's very useful. Our forefathers, they use it how wine was so important to our society and community for treatment and many other things. Many applications is there. So it is mentioned by my brother. So rice whiskey is accepted for distinction, and Lai people use it for treatment and health tonic. So he mentioned it. So we do the same thing. So the similarity is there. Traditional healing. Lai people are famous for traditional healing using the rice whiskey and the rice wine, variety of herbs, using stings of bees, and wasps, and healing using ritual methods for community ceremonial. Sacrifice of pig, chicken, releasing five live chicken, offer rice to the stream, which is known as Khayom Lakpa, etc., are performed for the relief and betterment of the individual or the community as a whole. So, for example, I have seen somewhere this Rakhan Bakhan. So, when some ill spirit is with us, so we pray to the ill spirit also to just release them. What is the pain and all. So this is traditional healing. Art of the warrior. Lai people have the art of learning to prepare for warrior, for war, I think so. This is called Thindung Saba. We have a different kind of a dance with this, the spear and the sword. That kind of a dancing that is called Thindung Saba. They are skillful in the art of the bow, arrow, spear, sword, shield, etc. But in the dead, at the time of the death, cremation ceremony is conducted with a secondary burial. That is two times after cremation, there will be secondary burial. So the kairin kaijao, it's in a means of transport carrying the coffin. Kairin kaijao is used to the coffin. It is decorated with a symbol of dragon, which is taken as one important culture of for the royal family, for someone especially endorsed by the royal family. And this indicates the Lai group are associated with the ruling administration. The soul of the dead is sent to the land where the forefather came from, Maya Water. Water is very important. The land of the forefather is known as Khamno. That earlier also mentioned about this. Reference given by my brother, Virachandra, this thing is given. So, this is not a problem. That's all. And see, he has written all about the basic of our community. So, this is my appeal to the today's presence, especially Sir Biren Bhukanji. We are just in the beginning of the revivalism of our Tai Lai. So, we are very poor and we are very much young. We are very young child. So, we need help from Sir Biren Bhukanji. So, we hope that all the time we will get help from Sir Bhukanji. And our amazing friends and others from the Tai home and maybe from Tai family and different Tai family. Without your support, it is known to me that it's next to impossible. That means your contribution will be always very useful for our Tai life. So please, I request all of you to extend helping hand when we need folks. Sir, even Bhukanji is there to provide us It doesn't mean that we will not give it back, we will give it back again. And whatever you have that written books and information, we like to collect it, just to reconstruct our timeline.